Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's look at some practical uses for Siri on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group and with its 750 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So I know a lot of people don't find Siri actually useful on their Mac, but there are some practical applications, some things that you could do with Siri that actually save you some time. So let's take a look at 10 Siri commands that you can really use. Now first, to use Siri on your Mac, go to System Preferences and then go to Siri. And there, check out what your keyboard shortcut is. By default, it's Hold Command Space. So a quick Command Space brings up Spotlight, but holding Command Space will bring up Siri. But you can change it to some other things, or you can customize and set your own shortcut. Now depending upon which Mac you've got, like if you have a newer MacBook, you may also have the option here to activate Siri with your voice. So you can do that as well. So first I want to show you how you can open a folder using Siri. So if I go in the Finder here and go to my Documents folder and then look in Work Projects, I've got folders like Project Alpha, Project Beta, Project Gamma. But instead of having to do all of that, I could just ask Siri to open that folder. So I use the keyboard shortcut and then ask Siri to do it for me. Open folder Project Alpha.
Here you go.
Now you could do the same thing with files. So notice here in my Work Projects folder I've got something called Daily Project Journal. So I can just go right to that file and have it open up in its default app. Open file Daily Project Journal.
Here you go.
Now there are always alternatives. So for instance, instead of saying file, I could say my, and it kind of knows what I'm doing. Open my daily project journal.
Here's what I got.
Now of course you can also use Siri to launch apps. Now it's pretty easy to launch apps from the dock, and you can also use Spotlight, but sometimes Siri might be a little bit faster. Launch text edit. Now you can use a lot of the productivity apps on your Mac directly through Siri. This can be faster than actually doing it in the app. For instance, if I wanted to add a new calendar event, I'd have to launch calendar and have to go to the date I wanted. I'd have to double click in there and create a new event and set everything. But I could just have Siri do it. I don't even have to have the calendar app launched to do it. Set up a meeting with John tomorrow at 3 o'clock.
Okay, I set up your meeting with John Smith for tomorrow. Ready to schedule it?
Yes.
Your meeting with John Smith is scheduled for tomorrow from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m.
You can even ask Siri to alter events like this. Change my meeting with John to 4.
Your appointment called meeting will be tomorrow from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. Ready to update it?
And notice I'm still not running the calendar app. It's even easier with reminders. It doesn't ask you to confirm. So I could do something like this. Remind me to take out the trash tonight at 6 o'clock.
Done.
You can see how it just added it to it right there. You could also just add something to the list. So I have a groceries list, so I can add to that. Add cookies to my groceries list.
Done.
And notice I'm still not running the Reminders app. Never even had to bother to launch it. But if I do, I can see there is take out the trash that was added. And if I go to groceries, I can see cookies have been added. Now you can also communicate directly with people without having to use the Messages or email app. So for instance in Messages I could say something like, send a message to John that I'll be late.
Here's your message. Ready to send it?
You could do the same thing with a whole email message. Send an email to John about tomorrow's meeting.
What would you like your email to say?
Just remember to bring all the documentation. Thanks.
Here's your message to John Smith.
So you can see there since I said about, it took the rest of it to be the subject. Otherwise, if I just said send an email to John Smith, it would prompt me for the subject and then for the body of the message. And notice that whole time I'm not even running the Mail app. Now one of the things I use Siri for often is to do calculations. Usually I'm in the middle of doing something like I'm coding or working in a graphics app and I need a quick calculation. I don't want to have to switch apps for that, so I'll just ask Siri for something. What's 7,263 divided by 7?
It's about 1,037.5714.
You could also do conversions. How many kilometers in 10 miles?
The answer is 16.09 kilometers.
So remember when you were young and in school and you first started to use the dictionary and they told you you could look up words to see how to spell them? And you thought, if I don't know how to spell them, how can I look them up in the dictionary? Well, thanks to Siri, you don't need to know how to spell a word to actually get the spelling. You could just ask using your voice. How do you spell precocious?
Precocious. P-R-E.
And notice it also brings up the dictionary definition. So you can ask Siri to get definitions as well without having to launch the dictionary. Just ask Siri to define and then the word. Now I like to listen to music while I'm working, and you can have Siri actually play DJ. You don't have to go and dig into the music app and find things. It works great if you have Apple Music because you can ask Siri to play anything in Apple Music. But it also works if you have your own library. So you should have the music app launched in order to do this. But if not, Siri will prompt you for that. Play Drive My Car. So here are a couple of bonuses that I really can't demonstrate for you for obvious reasons. The first is you can use Siri to put your Mac to sleep. Now if you ask Siri go to sleep, you just get a snarky reply. But if you say Mac sleep, it works. You can also go to the screensaver by saying activate the screensaver or just screensaver and it works. Now a few more tips here on using Siri. One is in system preferences here, if you don't want Siri to actually respond audibly to what you're saying, you can turn off voice feedback. This speeds things up a little bit and you don't always need Siri to respond when I can see Siri is actually doing the thing I asked. Also, if you want to see what else Siri can do, just activate Siri, but instead of saying something, wait. And then you'll see this help come up. And you could dig down into any of these categories and see what else Siri can do. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.